January 18th, 1917. Emile, still bedridden, beseeched Anna to travel to Saint-Mihiel to find his daughter and share the sad news of Carl's death. Anna set off immediately.
Calme-toi, le Pékin.
Hein? Voilà, dis donc.
murdered!
I'm sure to be now.
Yeah!
Their euphoria was short-lived, intercepted by German troops who still held Saint-Mihiel. Carl and Anna were led to the officers' quarters for interrogation. Carl was sent back to fight for the Germans, while Anna was sent to the infirmary to care for soldiers. On April 8th, the French forces launched an assault on Saint-Mihiel, an opportunity that Carl would not let slip by.
Gut gemacht.
Alter Fritte.
Hey, werk was ran.
Hepp runter nur.
Hey, zwurbel im Lack.
Guter Junge.
Briten! Walt!
Ja! Run! Hey, Brudin! Zutein! Okay, okay! Okay, let it go! Bums! Ja!
Freu mich da!
Go, go!
Gut gemacht. Guter Hund.
Ja. Hoch die Ups.
Oh,
While Carl was about to finally make it back home, Freddie was joining the Canadian troops stationed at Vimy. In the sky, George, a British aviator from the Royal Air Force, was spotting the German positions for artillery support. On this day, Canadian troops led the charge.
Come on!
so many failures and sacrifices, the Canadians finally managed to take the hill back from the Germans. The United States' entry into the war grew more certain by the week. The last letter from Freddie's younger brother confirmed his country's newfound eagerness to join the fight. Carl was within a few hundred yards of Emile's farm when the rumbling of the French air patrols began thundering through the April sky.
Good, you.
Let's go!
April 16th, 1917, Emile was still sick. But the general needed every soldier who could stand to launch his big offensive. Once again, it was to be the battle that would bring an end to the war.
Freddie!
Oh,
Freddie!
Fine.
Bien.
Un début.
Thank you.
The blow was fatal.
Oh.
The Nivelle offensive was a bloodbath, a butchery. Soon, mutiny spread throughout the French infantry divisions, and the offensive was abandoned. Emile was jailed with the other rebels, waiting to be court-martialed. The dogs of war, man's best and most loyal friend, shared the same day-to-day as the soldiers. Whether carrying messages, saving the wounded, or sweeping for mines, they never failed to fulfill their duty.
What?
C'est bien. Allez. Tiens bon, tiens bon. Carl, tiens bon. Allez, Carl. Voilà, tiens. Allez, allez. Carl, tiens bon. Allez, Carl. Voilà, tiens. Allez, Carl. Carl, tiens bon. Tiens bon, tiens bon. Ça va aller, allez. Voilà, allez, couche. Carl, tiens bon. Voilà. Allez. Allez, Carl.
Enough for Carl to forget 3 years of war and exile.
No, let's stay home.
After weeks without news of Emile, Marie finally received a letter from her father.
C'est l'heure.
Dearest Marie, as the war ends for me, I have no regrets. I've seen too much horror. I hope fate has been more merciful to you. Our time on Earth is brief. Has been filled with so much joy that I can only be thankful for how much I've been blessed. Most specially, for the wonder you brought into my life. This letter is my last. I've been found guilty by a military court for the death of an officer. It was not my intention to kill him. Makes men mad. Though I failed, Carl, I know my sacrifice has not been in vain. I fought for my country and my liberty. My honor is assured. Since it is the will of God to separate us on earth, I hope we'll meet again in heaven. Keep me in your prayers. Your loving Papa. Always.